Hello and welcome to Sportscaping Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Minnesota Vikings franchise series here in Madden 16 on the Xbox One. We have made the playoffs. Not only that, we have taken the top seed in the NFC. Yeah, same record as Green Bay, who we play today, but they had to play through the wild card round since we won the division on tiebreakers. And here we go. We get to host the Packers. This is the third time playing them this year. We've split the series so far, one game apiece. We won at home. They won at Lambeau, but this one's back home at TCF Bank Stadium. So here's the divisional round matchups. Green Bay and Minnesota, Philly and Seattle, to see who plays in the NFC Championship game next week. So Sean Hill forced back into action with another injury to Teddy Bridgewater. He'll be out this week. He would be available for an NFC Championship game. However, if they get there and Sean Hill leads them there, who do you start? I don't know. We'll have to get to that if and when the situation arises. But right now, the task at hand is playing a much better game than we did in Lambeau in Week 17. We want to set the tone with our offense. We get that first down from Matt Asiata. And on first and 10, here's a pass to Johnson. Charles Johnson going to spin close to first down yardage. Give him 9. It'll be second and inches. And Adrian Peterson looking to get the football on this play. He'll have more than enough for a first down, and he's across the 50 to the 49. Third and 2 now. Asiata back in the game at fullback, and again he gets the carry on third and short for the first down. So that's working out strategy-wise. We're hanging onto this football for a big portion of the first quarter, but down goes Sean Hill on the sack. And all of a sudden now, setting ourselves up in a bit of a spot as turns to third and 16. And Sean Hill doesn't see anything, so he runs and he slides down for the first down. Lots of room in front of Sean Hill. He recognizes that. And wow, they convert on third and 16 with a quarterback scramble. How about that? And it wasn't even Teddy Bridgewater, it was Sean Hill. Here's a pass to Kyle Rudolph, getting him down to the 3. It's going to be first and goal. This drive, this lengthy drive, continues for the Vikings, but they need to punch it in. First and goal. The pass is to Rudolph, and it's in the end zone. Vikings score first. What an impressive first drive. Hanging onto the football, pounding it with both their running game and the pass as well. Nice mix, and they end up in the end zone. That's exactly what Mike Zimmer wanted to see out of his team out of the chute here. So 7-0 Vikings. But here comes Aaron Rodgers and company, 3rd and 5 now at the 25, standing in that pocket and hitting the fullback, John Kuhn, out of the backfield. He's got the first down, making sure he hangs on to that. And the Packers have 1st and 10 at the 34. They get a 5-yard false start there, I believe. But then, Eddie Lacy goes down awkwardly, and the reason he did is because that's a face mask, I believe, on Anthony Barr. Going to be 15 yards. And it is going to set the Packers up with a first down. And they're right at midfield. Here's Rodgers. Nice throw and an even better catch right there. That's going to be Randall Cobb at the sideline, getting the first down catch at the Vikings 40. And now 3rd and 6 for the Packers. Stepping back and throwing. And, off the fingertips of Jordy Nelson. Had a hand on it, but he could not secure the catch. 4th down and 6, and the Packers have a decision to make. Nice throw by Rodgers. He tried to one-hand it. No, couldn't quite grip that thing. Maybe it's the cold. That actually hits him in the face mask, and then he gets popped by Blanton for his troubles. They're going to try over 50-yard field goal, about 54. It is up, and it is good for Mason Crosby. So the Packers have their first points of the game, and it's 7-3. But a nice job by the Vikings defense, well, I guess, to stop him there. Even though it was Jordy Nelson who dropped the football to help him out. Adrian Peterson stopped after a minimal gain, and it's even worse. Now you got a holding call. They'll definitely take that. It's against Chase Ford. And after a second down play, it's 2nd and 14. But Kyle Rudolph, who lined up in the backfield, has room to run at this short catch. And there he goes. He brings us to the 45-yard line of the Packers. Great design right there, getting Rudolph out on the flat with blocking ahead of him. And he just steamrolls down the field. So now Adrian Peterson cutting to the left. He's got a seam. 20, 10, touchdown AP. And we're on the board again. That sudden cut to the left fooled the defense, and they're exposed big time as the Packers now find themselves down 14-3 after this huge run by Adrian Peterson. You see, that play was designed to go inside. He bounces outside and finds a clear path to the end zone untouched, and a little flare at the end there. So the Vikings score on their first two possessions, now 14-3. Aaron Rodgers over the middle of the field is going to find Randall Cobb again, and they've got a first down at the 37. Second and one now. Rodgers taking that snap. He's going to hand off. No, it's play action. He's throwing, and he finds Jordy Nelson. He catches that one, and they're down to the Vikings' 31-yard line. Here come the Packers as they are moving it down the field now. Second and 10. Rodgers going to take off like Sean Hill before him, but he goes ahead first dive, trying to get that first down. He's going to be a yard short. Third and one now at the 22. They got Kuhn in the game at fullback in front of Lacy, but the Packers are not running. Looking to throw, scrambling, finds Jordy Nelson. He's going backwards, and boy, does he ever go backwards. They're not giving him any forward progress whatsoever. Fourth and 12 sets them back for another 50-yard field goal attempt just inside the left upright, and the Packers get another field goal, but they do not want to be trading field goals for touchdowns in this game, and that's exactly what's happened. Third and 6, Sean Hill throwing errantly right there on third down, trying to get Adrian Peterson, who was out wide one-on-one, trying to get him to run a comeback route there, but it did not work. They got a punt, so with a minute 6 left, there's a pick! Blanton steps in front of it and picks off Aaron Rodgers. So there you go. No more points for the Packers in this first half. As a matter of fact, this sets up the Vikings for one more shot at getting down the field themselves. 46-yard line. And this is to Kyle Rudolph. He's been busy in this first half. Timeout right there at the Packers 47. Second and 3. Hill has time to throw. And he's got Rudolph 20-15 down to the 11. And it's going to be first down. The clock is winding, 45 seconds and counting. You got 22 seconds now when they take the third and 6 snap. Sean Hill standing in there, throws to the back of the end zone. AP catches it, but he's well out of bounds. Didn't see him fast enough to get him. When he's in bounds, it's 4th and 6, and they'll bring on Blair Walsh to try to get those 3 points back and make it a 17-6 game. He's got the kick up and good, and the Vikings will take that 17-6 lead into the locker room at halftime. Now back out for the third quarter, and the Packers possessing the football. First and 10. Rodgers throwing. Nice touch right there to the sideline. It is James Jones making the catch. First and 10. 39 of the Vikings over the middle. Oh, there you go. They try to bring pressure. It doesn't work out so well. Good protection, and Randall Cobb is wide open. Down to the 15. That's his fifth catch already. So in the pistol formation now, Rodgers wants to throw again, except he's not going to be able to. Protection not so good there. 3 Vikings convene on him. And I believe Anthony Barr is going to get credit for that sack. Second and 17. They get it down to 3rd and 7 now. Rodgers trying to get the screen to Lacy, but no, they're not fooled. That is Terrence Newman over there making the tackle. It's going to be 4th and 8. And once again, they'll be forced to take the field goal. You see a dejected McCarthy on the sideline right there. Up and good as Mason Crosby's kick, but they need to punch it in the end zone here. This is just not going to work out for him. 17-9, 3rd and 7, Sean Hill waiting for his man to get open across the field. That's Jarius Wright for a first down right there. That's not very good coverage on 3rd and 7. You got to put a guy on him and make sure they don't get that easy first down. Speaking of easy first downs, it's Kyle Rudolph again down the field to the 16-yard line. Big-time target for Sean Hill today. Rudolph is a beast here in the passing game. So let's hand off to Adrian Peterson. Big hole right up the middle, and he's going to scurry for about 8 yards. Make it 9. Second and 1 there as the result. Mike Zimmer definitely liking what he's seeing here out of his offense today. Hand off to AP. Yeah, give him the first down. He's got the progress right there, and he's inching towards the 100-yard mark now with that big touchdown run he had. Play action, though, on second and goal, and it's Chase Ford in the end zone for the touchdown. There you go. The running game obviously setting up the pass in this situation here, as you got to honor AP, especially after the run he had earlier to beat you for a touchdown. And here, after a run play, they go play action and get it to Chase Ford, and he's in for the score. It's now 24-9. Sean Hill having a game here, taking care of the football, and he's got a couple touchdown throws. So here's Aaron Rodgers. Got to get working here with about 6:45 left to play. They can go up and down the field all they want, but they need to punch it into the end zone, and they need to do it a couple times here. Here's a pass that is going to be to Davante Adams, getting them a first down at the 41. Definitely a bend but don't break approach today for the Vikings defense. There's another pass. I believe that's to Janice. And they're down to the 26-yard line, second and one. And they'll hand off to Eddie Lacy, going to the right. He's going to bounce outside, get inside the 10, tripped up by Harrison Smith at the 9, but it's first and goal for the Packers. Pistol formation and Starks in the backfield. Here's a pass to the end zone, and there's their first touchdown of the day. It goes to Jordy Nelson, able to sneak it in there in front of the coverage, and now we've got a game again. With the extra point, it'll be an 8-point game. Could see an onside kick coming up here, and they could tie this with a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. So they opt not to go for the onside kick. The Vikings were lined up for it, but they kicked deep, trying to surprise them. Here's Patterson taking this back, 25, 30, 31. Yeah, that didn't work out so well for the Packers. They didn't pin them deep, and they didn't get the onside kick, so they kind of got caught in between there. Adrian Peterson with a huge first down run. Gets 9 yards. He's over 100, by the way. That'll set up second and one at the two-minute warning. Fullback in the game, and hey, it worked two other times. Why not give it to him again? Asiata gets the first down, and the Packers now have to start calling their timeouts. Second and nine now, and they've got one timeout left. AP up the middle. Nope. They were ready for that. And it'll set up a third down decision. Do you throw or do you be conservative and run? Third and seven. Well, he takes the sack, so he doesn't force a pass. But they will have to punt here. They're going to run this down all the way, take a timeout, and then kick it. So 54 seconds left. Rodgers on second and two finds his man for the first down. Is that James Jones, I believe? They spike it and now have 41 seconds left, second and 10. There's a pass to Jordy Nelson, close to a first down. 28 seconds left now after they spike it once again. And the shotgun snap, again throwing short to Corliss. That's not going to get them where they need to be. Third and four, they need to spike this thing again or go quickly. They get set and spike it with 13 seconds left, but now you've got fourth down and four. They need to convert or the game's over. They're going Hail Mary. We've seen Aaron Rodgers do this year in real life. It is incomplete. Falls to the ground. I think somebody may have had their fingertips on that. We got to take a look at the replay. But the bottom line is the Vikings are going to win this football game. In the scramble, oh, Jordy Nelson had a chance. Fingertips on that football, but could not bring it down for a catch. Packers are going to go down in a loss here. 24-16, victory formation, Sean Hill. Ha ha, that is junk, everybody. He's in the house to watch some real-life NFL playoff football today. And we're going to bring you some stuff here, live stream and Dualcom, because he doesn't know yet, but his Mets franchise video has not been commentated yet. But there you go, the Vikings. Moving on to the NFC Championship game. Yeah, that sounds very strange. Well, and no, we get to NFC Championship games. We just usually lose them. Well, I have Sean Hill because Teddy Bridgewater got hurt. He was out for 5 weeks, broken collarbone, comes back, and he gets broken ribs in his first game back in week 17. So now I've got a dilemma. I've got Sean Hill, who's won every game, like 6 games he started, and I've got Teddy Bridgewater back next week for the NFC Championship. I need to make a choice. Who would you guys go with? You don't think so? Sean Hill's been the man, though. He's really come through. You see all these numbers here. AP rushes for 100 yards, big touchdown again. Oh, your mic wasn't even on.
Yeah, well, nobody hears me.
They don't even hear you. They might hear you a little bit off of mine. Probably not. It sounds like I'm talking to myself, basically. Turn yourself on and say hi.
Yeah, hey, everyone.
There's Junk Gaming Videos, everybody. Yeah, so he's in the house. We're wrapping this thing up. Here you go. It's going to be Ravens at Patriots. Really? Ravens? Okay, Ravens at Patriots in the AFC. And the Eagles knock off the Seahawks. So it's going to be the Eagles coming to TCF Bank to take off the
Take off, guys. We'll see you next time. They're going to soar.
If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!